Hello guys, welcome to Akash Biology, and the topic that we'll be dealing today is nucleic acid. So before going into the detail of nucleic acid, let's have a review of its history. So the history of nucleic acid. So who discovered nucleic acid? It was discovered by Friedrich Miescher. And at that time it was not named as nucleic acid. So Friedrich Miescher named it as nucleine. Later on, a biologist named as Altman named it nucleic acid because of its association with the acidic nature. Now, who discovered the purine and the pyrimidine base? So there was a scientist named as Fischer. So Fischer discovered purine and pyrimidine base. Then, who discovered the purine and the pyrimidine base of DNA? So there was a scientist known as Cosell. So Cosell discovered the purine and the pyrimidine base of DNA. There are lots of purine and pyrimidine bases, but Cosell discovered only of the DNA. Now, after that, there was a scientist named as W.T. Eastbury. So he studied the nucleic acid by an X-ray diffraction study. Then he came to the conclusion that the nucleic acid are composed of polynucleotides. Nucleotides means they are composed of the nucleotides at a right angle to a common axis on which the nucleic acid, that is the DNA, is twisted and composed of various nucleotides, and the distance between nucleotides is 3.4 angstrom. So this was the assumptions or the study of W.T. Eastbury. So it is mainly asked in the entrance examinations. So which study? X-ray diffraction study. Then after that, there was a scientist named as Franklin. So Franklin discovered that the DNA is a helical structure. And from the study of W.T. Eastbury and Franklin, Watson, Crick and Wilkins prepared the structure of double helical structure of DNA, that is the B form of DNA that we are using in our syllabus. So this all is about the history of the nucleic acids. So now, what is nucleic acid? So like as the protein, fat, carbohydrate are the important macromolecules of the cell, similarly the nucleic acid is also an important micromolecule of the cells. So what is the nucleic acid composed of? So it is composed of nucleotides. So many nucleotides. So it is known as polynucleotides. Nucleotides. So nucleic acid is composed of polynucleotides. Poly means many. So it is composed of many nucleotides. So the functional unit of nucleic acid is nucleotides. So what does a nucleotide composed of? So it is composed of a pentose sugar. So pentose sugar, as the name suggests, it is a compound with 5 carbon. So 5 carbon compound. Similarly, the second one is the nitrogenous base. So they are aromatic heterocyclic base. And at last, there is inorganic phosphate. So it is in the form of phosphoric acid, and it is same in all nucleotides. Same in all nucleotides. So a nucleotide is named on the basis of type of pentose sugar and the type of nitrogenous base present in it. So what are the type of pentose sugar? So pentose sugar is composed of two components, are of two types, ribose that is present in RNA and deoxyribose that is present in the DNA. So it is present in RNA. So what is the difference between ribose and deoxyribose? So let us reveal the structure. So this is the structure of ribose. So this is carbon number 1, this is carbon number 2, carbon number 3, carbon number 4 and carbon number 5. So this is the structure of ribose. So we can see in the carbon number 2, the carbon is associated with the hydroxyl group, whereas in deoxyribose it is associated with only hydrogen atom, C2 position. So this is the main difference between the ribose and the deoxyribose, that in C2 position the ribose is associated with hydroxyl group, but here is one less oxygen atom, so it is associated with the hydrogen only. So this question is mainly asked in entrance examinations. Now coming on to the nitrogenous base. So as it is a aromatic heterocyclic base, it comprises of two groups, purine group and pyrimidine group. So purine group, it is a double ring structure. As a heterocyclic, it is a double ring structure, whereas it is a single ring structure. Double ring means more carbon, so 9 carbon are present over here, so C1 to C9, but here only the 6 carbons are present, so C1 to C6. Now what are the purines? There are two types of purines, they are adenine and they are guanine. So two carbons are, two purine bases are adenine and guanine. Whereas coming on to the pyrimidine, there are three types of nitrogenous bases in the pyrimidine group. They are thymine, that is present only in the DNA, cytosine, present both in RNA as well as DNA, and last one is the uracil, present only in RNA. So they are analogous to each other. So thymidine is present in RNA, but in the case of, it is present in DNA, but in the case of RNA, uracil is present in the place of thymidine. And inorganic phosphate is same in all. Now coming on to another thing, what actually is a dinucleotide? So as the name suggests, dinucleotide. So it is composed of two nucleotides. And what is a polynucleotide? So it is a polymer of nucleotide. So the two nucleotides are joined by phosphodiester bond. So and the thing that I have forgot to mention, so these both are known as nucleoside, and nucleoside plus inorganic phosphate will make nucleotide. Now coming on to another thing, so how will a sugar will associate itself with so this is a structure of pentose sugar. So in this position, that is the C1 position, it will be associated with either the purine base or pyrimidine base. So it will associate with the nitrogen number 6, and it will associate in the pyrimidine the nitrogen number 3 positions. Now in this position, that is 5th carbon positions, it will be dehydrated to form bond with phosphate. So this is one nucleotide, complete nucleotide, pentose sugar, phosphate plus purine base. Now it will be associated with another nucleotide like as this. It will be associated with the here. So C3 position. So So a phosphodiester bond will be formed between carbon number 5 of one nucleotide and carbon number 3 of another nucleotide. So this is all about the phosphodiester bond. Again it will be forming CH2, again one phosphate. I have not arranged the figures so well, but this is phosphodiester bond. Carbon number 5 of one nucleotide and carbon number 3 of another nucleotide. So carbon number 3 is originally associated with the hydroxyl group. So this all is about the nucleic acid. Now in next lectures I will be dealing about DNA. Thank you.